Hi guys, and welcome to this episode of Because I Said So. In this episode, it's a jewellery tutorial. So, if you want to know how to make these ones, then please keep watching. So, to make this tutorial, these are all the beads that you're going to need, so I'll just talk you through it. For these little peach, lovely rounded beads here, you will need two of those. I put a link in the description for everything. You also need two of the earring hooks. These are really cheap, so that's going to be fine. Even if you buy loads, if you have a plan on doing a lot of jewellery making your own or following my weekly tutorials on a Wednesday, then it's always good to have a couple of those. Like in my other tutorial last week with the heart earrings, if you don't have pierced ears, you can have clip-ons. I put a link in, it's fine. You will also need the actual settings for these. So the rounded beads that I've bought are actually 14mm, so this is going to be 14mm. If you want to go for a bigger or smaller size, that's fine, but make sure the setting that you use is always the same size as the actual beading, because if not, it just won't fit. So you'll need six of these teardrop ones, but I've got the clear crystal looking ones, which I like because once I put it in my hand, it goes all like yellowy and stuff, and I just think when you're walking out, it will just look lovely with all the colour combinations it will have. And finally, you will just need the jump rings. So I've gone for the 5mm ones, which are really, really tiny. I didn't want to go too big because I didn't want the beads to hang down too low, but I couldn't go any smaller than this because I still need to get them through the hole so they will attach on. In terms of tools, these are all the ones that you're going to need to complete the project. So I've got a pair of tweezers here that'll be helped with where to put the beads in the exact place. I've also got chain nose and round nose pliers. These are going to help with twisting out the jump rings to put them onto the beads. I've got, you need to put some kind of disposable like container. I didn't really have one. I've got like a plastic spoon that I can just throw away. It's fine. It's going to be useful because you're not going to use a crazy amount of glue, so you don't need the whole thing. You also got some cocktail sticks, and that will help you with mixing in the glue and then putting the glue onto the actual beads and areas. I've got this two-part glue. So this you need to be very careful with, just because you're not supposed to be reading the vape. Make sure you like open a window really wide. If you've got one of those masks, like a fume mask, then definitely put that on. If you can do it outside or somewhere where you can open a door, just in a well ventilated area, because you're not supposed to breathe in the fumes. Also some gloves. So the first step in this tutorial is to get the actual hook that will go, you know, through your ears onto the setting. So I thought, instead of using a jump ring and making the earring longer, because it already is quite, you know, a statement piece, you just kind of get the chain nose pliers and then you kind of bend it out a little bit. Move that little ball out the way. There's a tiny little space you can go through. So what you need to do, make sure that that is going to be facing the back and this is going to be facing forward when you do hook it on. So what you do is to grab that down. Like that. So then you've hooked on the actual setting to the hook. Using the same twisting out method as last week, so we just need the round nose and the chain nose pliers. What we're going to do is put these one jump ring onto each bead. So for this next bit, this is what I'm talking about, where you need to be in a well-ventilated room. So either open a window, open doors, put your fumes mask on and you're ready to go. Also put your gloves on. So once you've done that, you get one part of the glue. Only a small amount, very, very small amount, into your disposable container. So I'm gonna do mine here. Exactly the same amount of the other one as well. I may have done a bit too much, but if I work quickly enough, then it will be fine. So put those together, and then you get your cocktail stick, and then you mix them around. Make sure they're well mixed. So this is the trickiest bit. What you're going to do is to get your original hook and setting, get that, and then you turn it facing down. So what you need to do is get some of the glue on a cocktail stick, just to put a little bit on here. So make sure you don't get your glove stuck in the meantime as well, but make sure you put enough glue on. Then get one of your beads, any one that you want. So I've got the bead in my hand there, and where the join bit is, because I'm not near the glue, it's fine. Where the join bit is, there, if you can see that little join, that's what we kind of want to hide. We don't want that to be visible. Get some more of the glue. Not too much though, you don't want it to go crazy. You want to go crazy. Get some more of the glue. Don't glue your gloves, huh? And then get that onto the join bit there. And just hold it with the tweezers. Now you want to hold it the way that's going to be facing. So make sure that it's going to be facing that way. So that's going to be facing the front. You don't want the back. The back isn't the crystal bit. And you just hold that for about 3 to 4 minutes. Once the glue starts to get a little bit tacky, what you can do is carefully place it onto here, and it should be a lot easier to stick. When I did it before, I sticked it on straight away, and then it was really hard for it to stick down. So if you kind of put it on there very carefully, move it into the position you want. This is where the tweezers come in, where you can move it into whatever position you want, really. Once you have, hold it down a little bit, and then you can repeat the same with the other two. Once these are glued down or in place, you leave it for around 30 minutes. And the last step that you need to do is to turn this over. So by this point, this should have all, it's not going to be completely glued down, but it would have glued down enough for you to turn it over and for not any of the beads to move. So you turn it over and you're going to stick that bead into the setting. So what you need to do is mix a little bit more glue. Obviously at this point, the glue would have dried. Get some of that and put a thin layer into the setting. And you get this bit and hold that up, get this. Put the bead in. Press it down ever so slightly. I need to move it to position a little bit. That's it. And leave it for 1 hour. And that's it. Until next time, guys, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon.